Goze brada doze braga dada iko shalaba imondo le grada dosa taka barada doze braga dadosha ibondo robo bobosha le brada doze braga daba ibondo ze grada dosha la brandi barada doze brada doze braga dada ibarada doze abate basha taka baya ilando ze pronto kabaya ilondo lo prosekete basha la branda doze bunda gada basha kotoze la bragadia Bandolo bobo shalababa, I brada do shalabrada do zarabahati, ban shalababa, I lolo bosha, barada da da doza, barada da doza, bosha chaka parada dea, mondo robo bosha la 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 bande, borada doze braga da da, bashantaya, boraba baba sete, bondele gonde ze goda basha, I mandoze grada dosha, barada da doze braga da da, barada da bazora da dosha, bakose teke. Oh, hallelujah. Once again, we are praying and thanking God for the excellence and beauty of today's program. Lift up your voice and thank God for the beauty, for the excellence, for the healings, for the miracles, for the impartations, for all the songs that we will hear and minister unto God. Thank Him for the beauty, for the excellence, for the honor that we are going to lift up our voice unto God. Bo shala baba hasate, bo rababa baba sha, lendo zegra baba hasate teya, shala la la bazo. Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for the beauty, for the excellence, for the healings and the miracles that will take place today. With one voice, with our hands lifted up, we sing praise and honor and adoration unto your name, O Lord. Radada doze bradadasha, Icatala gradadoza, and the Groshalaba, Ipanta Jose Catala Brade, Ashalababa, Ibo Radadoze Grabahata, Icatata Rabazone Grosha, Borada Rabasha, Bordala Gazele, Bordala Bahata, Radada Rabasha, Bola Basote Cabarabaya. We see the glory of God over this auditorium, Borde Grabahasa, Radada Rabasha, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lifted up, won't talk about it. Rababaya, oh Rabasata, everything, won't go over Shalaba without soul and spirit. Banta Rada da Rosha, Rede Zorabasha, oh Delebobo Shalaba, Ika Dose, Bongo Roba Bosha, Iba Rababaya, Rababaya, from the depth of our heart, now we sing praise and honor, won't take care of Rambo Rabosha, Rabobosha, Ratata, we display the beauty and excellence of our Lord Jesus Christ. This year, shout of praise 2023. We see miracles, we see healing by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. What an honor and privilege to lift up our hands and voice this night. Oh, toka sateya, rebo rebo shata, barada doze kete, oh shalababa, reba baba sham, reba rebo sham, bata ta ta ta, barada rebo shalaba, ika kosa ta ta, rebo shakaba. The name of our Lord Jesus Christ shall be lifted up. The name of our Lord Jesus Christ shall be glorified this day. Oh, Radarosha, Shakabu, O Shakaba, Rabba Babaya, Leba Babaya, Testimonies of O Sataya, Lego Robo Shakataya, O Rabba Babaya Sati Kadaba. Lift up your voice and thank God. Thank God for answered prayer. Thank Him, thank Him. O Rada Roskatabahati, Shala Baba Baba Zora Baba Satalaba. O Rada Rose Katoshka Bahatiya. Mande zo ronde le trabaha sota kabasha la la mosha ela losa mosha kata la gadose grabaha sote oh rabababaya. Father, we thank you for the beauty, for the excellence, for the miracles, for the impartation, for the fellowship. Manto sakata rabasati oh rabababaya. Father, we see your glory everywhere. Bonte kabarabaya. Lord Jesus, we thank you. Holy Ghost, bonte le grabaha sote kaya. Father, we thank you. We honor you. In Jesus' mighty name, shall we all say amen. Thank you, Pastor Sir, for the opportunity to lead this session of prayer. Let's clap our hands for our man of God. Once again, you are all welcome to Shout of Praise 2023. Shout glory! Shall we invite the choir? You are Hallelujah! 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 Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! The program is Shout of Praise, not Silence of Praise, not Gentility of Praise, not Calmness of Praise. We are here to shout. Praise God! We are here to shout. So don't be left out. I with me. Are you with me? If you can hear me, raise your hand. Lift up your hands like that. Be on your feet. Be on your feet now. Be on your feet. Be on your feet. We are going to shout. Are you ready? Are you ready? Shout glory! 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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's have our seats. First, I want to thank the esteemed pastor, my good pastor, for the opportunity to take this remark. Sir, it is a great privilege to be here, and I don't take it lightly at all. Hallelujah. Good evening, good afternoon to all of us, and wherever you are watching us from, if it is morning, good morning to you. You are welcome to Shout of Praise 2023. Shout glory! Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Choir looking very beautiful. You are very prepared. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So this program was prepared specially for us by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Our man of God received this instruction and inspiration from the Holy Spirit to have this program with us every year. Don't let this year be like last year for you. Are we together? Let this year be very special for you because you are here in Shout of Praise 2023. Don't be calm. Say, I'll not be calm. Say, I'll not be calm. Say, I'll not be quiet. See, I can see you from here. If you are quiet, I know. So say, I will not be quiet. I will shout. And I'll shout in praise. Hallelujah. Let me tell you a very quick story about King David. King David was the king of Israel, the only king who never lost a battle. And the amazing thing about King David was that he was a musician. He liked to sing songs to God. He liked to sing praises to God. Hallelujah. And today we are talking about King David because King David was a man of worship, a man of praise. And the Lord gave a testimony of him. He said that this is a man after my own heart. Hallelujah. Maybe somebody invited you to be here. Maybe you saw the flyer, you saw the banner, and you chose to be here. You are welcome. You are the right place. All right? You are the right place. So let your being here be very significant in your life. For some of you, you're expecting a miracle. It is happening from here. Hallelujah.
For some of you, you want to see something new in your life, in your family, in your school, in anything that concerns you. As we are singing in praise, sing along. As we are dancing in praise, dance along. As the man of God walks up the stage and teaches us, pay rapt attention and don't lose any word that is coming to us today, whether in songs or in sermon. Hallelujah. 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 So don't be calm. Don't be gentle. Grab everything. Okay? Like a hungry person, grab everything. Participate fully. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. See, the angels of the Lord are here. Wave your hands. Wave your hands. The angels of the Lord, an army of angels, they are here. And they are here to answer prayers. Hallelujah. And God Almighty himself is here. He's here to receive our praise. Hallelujah. So make sure you're a part of it. Make sure you're a part of it. Enjoy every moment. Look at this beautiful choir. They've rehearsed all night because they are leading us on a triumphant procession. So as they sing, we sing with them. Even if you don't know the song, look on the screen. You see the lyrics. Sing along. Sing along. The Bible says that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty. Okay, and this weapon are the words of God. It is not knife. It is not axe. It is not gun. It is the words that we say in words and in songs. And we are here to sing songs. We are here to shout to the Lord in songs and praise. So make sure, those are the top. Are you listening to me? Make sure you are not distracted by anything. All right? We are not here to play. Don't be distracted. Don't look around. Just focus on everything that the Lord is doing upstage here. And by the time you are leaving here, trust me, there will be a testimony for you to share. Say amen. There will be a testimony for you to share. Say amen. Say there will be a testimony for you to share. Say amen. Hallelujah. So once again, I want to welcome you, esteemed pastors and leaders here, deacons, elders, leaders, all of us here. We want to welcome you to 2023 Shout of Praise. It's going to be a glorious time. It's going to be a major time in your life. We are in the last quarter of the year. Every expectation you had for 2023, even if you lost hope because of this program, the hope has been brought up to our life. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Say this with me. Say, Lord God. Come on, shout. Say, Lord God, I am ready. Lord God, I am ready. I'm ready to shout. I'm ready to shout. I'm ready to sing your praise. And there'll be a miracle for me. In Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, esteemed pastor, sir, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here. I'm here to receive my miracles. And I have testimonies to share. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much. Thank you. I enjoy every moment. All right? Enjoy every moment. Thank you. God bless you.
Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Why don't you be upstanding? Lift your hands. Give God all the glory. Let's worship His Majesty. Hallelujah. Oh, bashata la la basete de bashata. Liba som to bradio si antara bahasa tala la baya. Oh Lord, we give you all the glory. Harabasa tala la baya. Oh, la bashara badera bara. Oh,
Yeah. Working God. Oh, don't say,
hallelujah.
Just to say, I'm not In our midst, this church, so amazing, and they want to display a skill, but this skill has to do with dancing. So I want you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the performance from Faithland Teens Church. Oh, give it up for them. Oh, clap, clap, clap. I want to see you clapping. I want to see you clapping. In fact, the audio is from Italy. And it's on the, in fact, on the sea coming. So, before that audio lands in Accra, in fact, Ghana, Kotoka, before it comes to maybe Amasamai, and then hitting Kutunze Faithland. So what we're going to do right now, there is another set of dancers. They will come back. Guys, please give me 1 minute. Stand here for me. Let's clap for them. They will come back. But I want to invite Pastor Isaac's crew. If they are not here, then I would... Yeah, so another set is ready. And dancers, can we have you on stage? Oh, let's give it up for them. Oh, let's give it up for them. Wonderful. The next set is ready. Pastor Isaac's crew. Pastor Isaac's crew. Please, where are
my soul. You told me sorrow to party. My life is a testimony of your grace and your love. In the force of my mind, I love to know. See your love in the shark to know. See your grace in the sweet to know. Now please sing me that tune. I want to get down.
I can feel my love around. Somebody, boy. I want to dance, oh Lord. I want to dirty myself. See my life. See what the Lord has done. I cannot explain. I feel like I want to sum my thoughts. Like I want to sound my song. I really want to touch in my soul. Sound my song. I feel like I want to sound my song. I feel like I want to sound my song. I feel like I want to sound my song.
Oh, is that all you can do? Is that all you can do? I can't hear you. Somebody give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah. I want to use this opportunity to thank my man of God, Pastor Kofi Blankson, for this opportunity to share a brief thought with God's people. I'm going to share on a topic. It is time for workshop. I'm sure choristers are here because we invited choristers. So I'm going to share briefly on how to raise a choir. How to raise a choir and maintain it. How to raise a choir. In fact, a strong one at that. How to raise and maintain a strong choir. Now, the word choir comes from the word called chorus. Choir means chorus, which is two or more people harmonizing. When there is one person, we call it solo. When there are two, we call it duet. When there are three, we call it trio. Four, quartets, and so on and so forth. But when there is about 10, 15, they are called chorus. And they say a choir. Now, briefly, how do you, if you are a choir director, how do you raise people in your choir? How do you do that? Number one, it has to start in the place of prayer. Are you careful choir leader? The first thing you have to do is to be prayerful. You have to see the people in the spirit before the manifestation in the physical. You have to be very prayerful as a choir leader. The second thing you have to do, I won't keep long because of time. The second thing is you have to be a good communicator. How well do you communicate with your members? How well do you treat them? Is it because you are at a position they are not? In fact, some of the choir settings, you realize that some of the members are even older than the leader. So you have to know how to communicate to them. Paul told Timothy, he said, you are not supposed, you can never rebuke an elderly in the church. You should never. Because God respects age. He respects age and experience. So you have to be somebody who is able to express your views in a polite way. Communicate very well to the people. And it has to be so they understand what you mean. Number three, are you approachable? You are mean. or you are that stand guy, or that lady that you say, hey, if Kwalida is coming, everybody is trying to run away. No. You ought to be approachable. Every one of the members has to be able to come to you. If there is any challenge, they should be able to communicate to you or express their views to you. Number four, this is where we have a lot of challenges in our churches, especially the choir. Are you well prepared? Leaders, they don't even know what they are about. I think there is too much noise. Ushers, please, can you work on the kids at the back? Are you well prepared? Do you know what you are about as a choir leader? Do you know your role? Do you know your duties or your responsibilities? Or they just call you a choir leader and that's all? No. Some of them, especially when it comes to teachers, they don't know anything. So when they go to choir rehearsals like this, they will say, Madam, sing this one. Hey, I like what you are singing. So they will try to name it. So they will tell you, we have soprano, we have treble, we have tenor, we have alto. Who told you there is a voice called treble? There is nothing like a treble voice. There is no voice, I repeat. There is no voice treble. We don't have a treble voice. A treble voice has to do with song. But ask yourself, as old as do you still breastfeed? You don't. Now you crack the bones, right? So when you are young, you are a teenager from age 3 up to like 12 thereabout, we all have what we call the treble. So when we go to primary schools, for instance, and they are in worship, you will not hear them harmonizing. They all sing the same thing, both male and female. They sing the same thing. That is treble. But when you grow, the treble voice is a housing. It contains all the 6 vocal parts. In fact, there are some twisted ones. So we have like 8 or 9 of them, which I will make mention. So the treble house all these voices. So when you grow, when you enter your adolescent age, now the men will have broadened chest, breakage in voice, all those developments. When they happen physically, your vocal also changes. So the females to one side, where they have 3 vocal parts. Namely, we have the soprano, which is their highest voice. Then we have mezzo-soprano, which is their normal voice. So when a lady or a woman starts to sing, the voice that comes out is called mezzo-soprano. Then when that lady sings a bit lower, she is singing alto. So these are the 3 for the females. And then when you go to the males, they have the tenor. Tenor is a male highest voice. Then they come to what we call baritone. So when a man tries to sing without going high or very low, he is singing baritone. Then we come to the bass. That is when German wants to do, you know, the other point. So they sing bass there. So these are the 3. Now we have what we call contra alto, a twisted tenor. We have the higher alto, higher tenor, all those things are there. Because of time, let me quickly finish and we move on. The next thing is, as a choir leader or director, you have to be understanding. You have to be understanding. When a member raises any concern, you should listen to the person, not to trash whatever idea that comes. No, you ought to listen. The next thing is, you have to be fun and inspiring. You don't have to be so mean throughout rehearsals. Be fun and be inspiring to your members. And the next one is, break from your character. As a choir leader, you ought to break from your character. What I mean by that is that, let's say, myself and Pastor Albert, we stay in the same area or in the same house, and we do to have some common things we do. When I come for rehearsals, that attitude has to stop. When you come to the house of God, you ought to be serious. Not to just or do the same thing you are doing with the person when you were in the house. No. When you come, everything has to be formal. After closing, you can do your informal thing. So you ought to break from your character. And then the last but one, you have to be studious. You have to learn new things so that you can teach. Don't be that ignorant choir leader who doesn't know anything. Your members have to teach you. It's good to learn, but from your members, but you have to be studious. Learn. So they know that this guy knows what he's about. The next one, I think that is all for today. God bless you all as we wait for our man of God to climb the stage. Thank you so much. Oh, is that all you can do? You can do better. Hallelujah. We want to give God a praise. We want to give God the honor. We want to give God the glory. Because he's been good. He has been so good to us from the beginning of this year till now. Why can't you just lift your hands and say, God, we bless you.
Odoma Kuma and nothing can would in the beer. Odoma Kuma, she ran cowed in. Odoma Kuma, they shall make good to woe, Miss Sorrow. Odoma Kuma, hallelujah. My body not Chirobia.
If I will know Miami, I want to be great. If I did want to hear you, Yamme, Debbie, I will Yamme, Annie, ain't you now? So I'm going to day. Debbie, I can see, I can see some of us. I want to go. If I did want to hear you, I can see some of your rent to me, but I was great. And it's a body. Body in our uncle, so no mammy, uncle Ponko. Oh, but I am the son. Why Koran, a betting meeting, send a waiting, say a boya. Won't go out, a catapia. Why Koran, a betting meeting, well, pray before. Mamma, the riding uncle Pony.
Good to all, Miss Sorry,
Kuma,
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
So magnify your name. Lift your hands. Can you lift up your hands at this moment? Oh, Sharaka Satitis. Rabaka Sataka Babas. Rosata Rabasekiti. If you can speak in other tongues, blast out in tongues right now. Blast out in tongues right now. The miracles have started. Blast out in tongues. Speak in tongues voraciously at this moment. Speak in tongues. Put your hand on your belly and speak in tongues. Bring forth beauty. Bring forth that pregnancy. Bring forth that child. Bring forth that healing. Bring forth that money. Mako shakabata kasi. Roka paske parabashata baha. Bring forth that peace. There's a peace the Lord wants to grant unto you. Reko shaka baba. Bring forth that promotion. Balikos ko parakus kate. Reko baba baba baba. Maskiro sharada. Maskiro sharababa. Reketere bobo sharababa. Reke baba baraba sharaba. Bring forth that rent. Mareko sharaba. Bring forth that car. Maraba sheke dede. Leka barabosa. Bring forth that land. Right now in this service, things are happening. Bring it forth. Marako sharababa. Marako sharababa. Marako sharababa. Mataka baraba sete. Reka baraba kata. Mataka baraba kata. Leka baraba shota. Leka tarababa sharababa. Sataka baraba. Lift your hands. Oh, shakatara babari. It has happened. Whatever you brought forth, it has happened. Whatever you brought forth, it has happened. Check your body, there's healing. Check your account, there's money. In the name of the Lord Jesus. If you came here disturbed, the Lord grant you peace. In the name of Jesus. Have started. If you need healing in your body now, put your hands there. Oh, Marabashiki di Borabo Satadi, Labashata Badi, Mo Cabradi, Siprada, Ro Crudo Sabradi, Maze Brado, Maze Brado, Bazo Brade Sata. Put your hands there now. The power of the Holy Ghost touch that body now. And in the name of the Lord Jesus, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, you have been made whole. You have been made perfect. That sickness is gone. That infirmity is gone. That disease is gone. All watching from online, I tell you, something is happening on the internet right now. The Lord is healing your body right now. In the name of Jesus. The Lord just whispered to me. The Lord said he wants to heal some pockets. We didn't come for just body healing. We came for pocket healing. There's nobody who does not need more money. The more you get money, the more you want it. And if you don't have it at all, you need more of it. This is the first miracle today. Put your hands on your pockets. Touch it like this. This pocket, it's a point of contact to your bank account. Makuska, tuska, tuska, tuska. Makuska, tuska, tuska, tuska. Makuta, skuka, tuska, tuska. This pocket is a point of contact to your bank account, to your momo account. In the name of Jesus. From this shout of praise, monies you have never seen before, receive money into your pockets in the name of Jesus. I see two people. You have built to the what they call a lentil level. It looks like things are becoming difficult for the roofing. The Lord says he is giving you money for the roofing right now. Receive money for the roofing. Receive money for the roofing in the name of Jesus. I see two people. You have a loved one who is at the hospital even now, and you came to this meeting by faith. Money to pay the bills in that hospital is a challenge. By the power of the Holy Spirit, not only will God heal that your brother, your sister, or your mother, the Lord is giving you money to pay all the bills in the name of Jesus. Right now, the healing power of God's Spirit flows from here to that hospital bed. And they have been healed. And they have been healed in the name of Jesus. All of you students, God says, I should tell you, if you are in primary, if you are in JHS, if you are finished JHS, if you are in SHS, you are finished SHS, if you are in university, the Lord says, I should tell you, he is giving you extraordinary comprehension from this shout of praise. When you study, you will understand. You will be the best in your class. The Lord is giving you speedy comprehension of education. Whatever you learn, you understand with speed. I have two parents here. The Lord says, I should tell you, you have been crying. Say, your crying is over. Your crying is over. You have been crying over a child. That crying is over. In the name of Jesus. I hear the Holy Spirit telling me there are people that are finding difficulties in taking a decision. And if not for this meeting, you are going to take the wrong decision. But by the power of the Holy Ghost and his mercies that is available right now, you will take the right decision. And that right decision will bring glory to God. That right decision will promote you. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I see people who want to receive capital. I see about 200 people like that here. You want capital to start a business. Your miracle has started. Your miracle has started. The money is coming. The money is coming. You come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands. Maraba shata baba baba. Roko tara baba baba shata baba baba baba. Leketere baba baba shata baba baba baba. Leka baba raba baba shata raba baba. Leketere bo shata baba haya. Roko bo shata raba baba dede. Mantoko bo shata baba baba. Thank you, Jesus. Lift your hands. Raba shata baba.
Carfuji Yajiwa Semidio Sewe Fringe Mapasi Woody Becko Yapa.
Sing it with me.
Oh, no carfuji Yajiwa Semidio. Woody Becko.
When you penny so, the money is dollars. He's waving it. He's waving it. Listen. Ha shata ka baba rabo shata. Leke rebo shada baba baba baba. It's not by might. It's not by power. By my spirit. Say it. No by might,
it's no by might,
no by power,
it's no by power,
by my spirit,
by my spirit.
Hey, Jarabako, so sing it to him. Prophesy to that person. Say, this mountain, it has been removed. It's a prophecy. Sing to that person. This For a moment, sit down. A few thoughts. We're going to move into the miracles. Thank you, Father. Oh, shatarabara. Thank you, choir. You may be seated. Let's clap for the choir. They look powerful. Are you enjoying yourselves? The power of the Holy Spirit is here right now. And I want to share some few thoughts with you that will move into another level of just the supernatural, just miracles. Hallelujah. Come on, shout glory. I can hear you shout glory. Tell your neighbor, I made it. Say, I made it. I made it. I made it. I made it. Say, it has happened. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Why are we here? We are here to praise God. We call it shouts of praise. The shouts of praise is a very powerful statement. Because kings shout, praise God. And when we shout for praise, there's a reason. Please help the kids for me. Ushers, do your job and help the kids for me. I promised sharing some few thoughts on a music workshop, but I can't move into that. So I'll give you just 5 points. I'll give you 5 points so that we can delve into the next level. And it's not a long meeting at all. It's a meeting that I have a few minutes. I want to close. I promise closing by 6. From 2 to 6, and that's what we're going to do. In shout of praise, the important thing is the miracles. Hallelujah. Are you ready? Are you ready to hear something from the throne room? Isn't the choir looking powerful? Let's give them a big hand. I would like to thank the committee members, the pastors, everyone that, you know, put money together to make this program a great success. I want to appreciate all of you. I want to give you 5 points under the music ministry. The music ministry. Number one, everyone can praise and worship. Ushers, you can do better than this. You just cannot stand until the noise has come down. You just can't sit until the noise is totally down, please. If they want something to eat or drink, please get for them. You have to do your job now, please. Let them sit down. Whoever is taking them, tell them we'll close in the next 30 minutes. Ushers, give that announcement. We will close in the next 30 minutes, so they should sit down. Can somebody help me tell them, please? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number one, everyone can praise and worship. Number two, praise is not dance and lifting of handkerchiefs. In our part of the world, we have been taught that praises is when we sing fast songs and when we dance. That has been a lie from the pits of hell. Ushers, you can do better than this. One of them can be up. As they are getting up, somebody is controlling them. Somebody should get up there, please. If the noise has not come down, I cannot continue. Okay, can one of the pastors help me? Just find a way to control them for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's be fast with this. So, the man of God, Pastor Chris, has taught us important things. Very, very important things. About praise. Praise, it can be as slow as worship. It's not praise that makes us dance and throw our handkerchiefs. No. So when you go to a Ghanaian church and they say it's time for praises, then you see them, you know, it's a wrong move. It's a wrong education from the kingdom. We don't know the pastors that put that there. But that is very wrong. So the man of God, Pastor Chris, has tried to help us understand what true praise is. I would like to read some few scriptures. Maybe if I do, I may exceed time. So let me just go to point two. Point three, right? That's point three. Worship is not slow, as we have been taught. Worship is not slow. Praise is not fast. In the number two. Number four, the conflict of pastors or churches and instrumentalists. This is one of the biggest challenges in the body of Christ. And I'm going to just use a few minutes to teach you something about that. The pastors make mistakes. The instrumentalists make mistakes. So there's a conflict. Sometimes we see these instrumentalists as demons. Not all of them are demons. Most of the time, it depends on how we treat them. I went to school. I studied music. All right? So I wanted to analyze something. Then I read first degree, I read second degree. When my colleagues were learning maybe medicine or banking, and after school they became bankers. I'm also supposed to do something with my profession. So now I'm speaking for the instrumentalists. They say yes. After that, I will speak for the pastors. Because I stand in the position of both of them. Do you understand? I'm a musician. I'm a pastor. So that fight, I'm inside. Sometimes I'm here with the instrumentalists. Other times I'm here. But the few things I'm going to share with you to help all of us. So if I've finished all these books, I paid my hostel fee, I paid my school fees, and I mean all those big fees we paid in school for 4 years, and some of us 6 years, because we did extra 2 years for degree. Then I come to a church, then the pastor tells me, oh, do it for God. It's a talent. Do it for God. Even if you have gone to school, it's the house of God. So the question is, how do I even pay for my transport? How do I pay for my transport coming to church? Or a renowned musician who has a band, and mostly they go to studio to rehearse. They practice. He pays this instrumentalist. Then you have invited this big man to a show. Then you said, no, it's for God. Maybe give some one Ghana cedis appreciation. So it's a big issue with the pastors. Pastors are not supposed to do that. And until you solve that issue, you are continually going to have a problem with instrumentalists. Continually. No prayer can solve it. It's the truth. So you treat them well. All right? If they have to be paid, let me tell you, everybody, love was singers. That is the singers we have in Christ Embassy. Now, Pastor Chris has camped them. It's their job. Pastor Chris buys car for them. He pays for the accommodation. It's like, you know, they work with the Levites, with the priests. Because you cannot do this kind of, you know, we are having your love war special. We are having healing school. They are ministering all the time.
What do you expect the person to do? What work can he do and still get time to come and be following Pastor Chris? So Pastor has calmed them. And he pays them very well. So if you see Pastor Chris raising millions and hundreds of instrumentalists and musicians, he takes good care of them. Of course, no matter what you do, there will be, you know, disloyal people. Pastor Chris has raised people like that who has become very disloyal. But this current generation, this is their work, to minister on the altar. Pastor Chris is the one that gets awards for musicians. He can give somebody $100,000. Most of our awards, we do it every year. This is about 3 years ago. $100,000 for winning maybe the artist of the year or the song of the year. So we need to treat them well. These musicians don't understand, just serve God. And even if they want to serve God, just understand where I'm coming from. Some of them are even married. They have children. They pay school fees. How do you expect them to take care of themselves? Is it a good question? This one, if the instrumental did not clap for me, I would have been surprised at them. Okay, so let me come to the pastors. Do I have some pastors here? So the pastors will tell you, now I'm coming to speak for the pastors. But their first error is that, just serve God. Just serve God. I have been able to maintain my keyboardist, who is clapping there, because I have to camp him. Otherwise, you won't get sick. You won't get them. I'm telling you the truth. If you're a pastor here, take that advice. No prayer can change it. I'm telling you. I'm telling the truth. When he came first, I paid for his fees. I paid for his accommodation. That's what I did for him. I paid for his fees for a diploma program that will last for about 2 years. I said, this is what I want to do for him, because until I'm wise enough to do that. And that same person, very soon you'll be a pastor. I know you want to dodge. But you see, we raise people and you see, we have to understand them. We have to agree to disagree. That's the point. If you don't understand their level and raise them from there, you can't get them. So pastors, don't make that mistake. One of the greatest musicians that ever lived in this world, that is a man of God too, is Pastor Chris. He does very well for his musicians. And we know that music is a very important part of ministry. Just imagine this beautiful program going on without music. And they are playing quality, standard. So you need to invest in them. Otherwise, you won't get them. It's the truth. Okay, so let me talk to you now. Sometimes, so these are the two kinds of musicians or instrumentalists in the church. Number one, they are people that are working and they still have the music as a talent. Those first category of instrumentalists, they are supposed to serve God with the talent because they are working. Pastors, you should be happy with me now. There are two kinds of instrumentalists. After all that I said, consider these two kinds. Whoever falls within you, know how to take care of them. The first category of people are those, maybe he's a banker. He works in a bank, right? And he's also a church organist or pianist. Because he's working in a bank and the bank is already paying him, if it's a son in the house, he's not supposed to take money. It's the truth. So if you're an instrumentalist and God has blessed you, maybe your man of God gave you a prophecy. You got a job. They are paying you well. You still want to take money for 1 hour playing. Those are the ones that demons enter them. Because it's no longer about church. It's about money. You know, that kind of Then the second category of instrumentalists are those, like myself, like I told you, who study music as their profession. For them, you need to pay them. B, point B under that, even if they do not go to school to study music, and it's more like they feed on the music, because you, as the pastor, you know that they don't really do any other job. All that they do is their talent. You need to pay them. It's the truth. Otherwise, it will be batons. This instrument will give the baton to, the baton to this person. You'll be changing instrumentals every 2 weeks. And the challenge is that when you need them most is when they will disappoint you. But there's a wisdom in it. There's a way you can deal with them. It's not everybody that can stay with you. Those that can stay with you, you know them. That's the number one. There are those that will stay with you for a while. When it's time for them to go, they have to go. Once you try to keep them, you will have more problems. Then there are those God has sent them to be with you forever. So you need to have a spiritual eyes and the insight to know the category of people. If you deal with this A like this B, you always have a problem. Deal with different instrumentalists differently. And the Lord recognizes their effort to the body of Christ. So if you don't do it, and because of the fact that you don't do it, and the church is not growing, God is going to hold you accountable for that. Is my workshop okay? Is it okay? Let me tell you what I want to do. I'm saving money. I promise them that I'm expecting some money. When the money comes, they should make sure the program goes well. I will take them to the best restaurant in town. I've done it before. I think 2018 or was it 2018 or 2019? Where is Ivy? When we went to DNR, we have gone twice. One of the Turkish restaurants in East Legon. I drove them there. I paid their transport. We ate. They must eat to play. They must eat to sing. There are times, I said, we are on the show. So, I owe you what? What do I owe you? What do I owe you? Because you look powerful. And you are singing powerfully. By the way, we are going to have a dinner next month. There are different kinds of programs. That dinner, we are not going to sing plenty. We are just going to eat from morning till evening. Until the food come from our nose. I've been telling them. Next month. And I'm going to, the choristers are going to be my guests. They will invite all of you. We will eat from morning till evening. I'm saving for that. Hallelujah. So that is, have I done justice to that conflict? If you're a pastor and you are here, if you don't take that advice, it will not work. I'm telling you. Especially when God brings very humble, loyal people. Do everything to keep them. There are people that when you see them, you just know that they can't be with you. You know. By prophetic eyes, by physical sight, you know that, no, this guy. But when God brings some humble people to you, their heart is in the work. Do them fine. Hallelujah. Point five. Your greatest weapon in life is your praise and confession. Please write it down. Your greatest weapon in life is your praise and your confession. When you want to deal with issues, you must praise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And at this level, I want you to prepare your hearts. The Lord is about to do something supernatural. Acts chapter number 10. I have a lot of scriptures for you, but because of time. Acts chapter number 10, verse 38. We all know that scripture. The Bible says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed, for God was with him. I want to read another scripture to you from Jeremiah chapter number 33, verse number 14. Jeremiah chapter number, thank you, Jesus. I know you came for a miracle, but put the scriptures down as we delve into that level. Jeremiah chapter number 33, verse number 6. Thank you, Jesus. Say, behold, I will bring it health and cure, and I will cure them and will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. Luke chapter number 2, verse 13. Luke 2:13. My God, my God, my God, my God, my God, my God. Hey, 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 hey. My God, my God, my God. It's burning. Luke chapter number 2, verse 13. My God, thank you, Lord Jesus. Le kazo barama sota kabarebo sharabade. Le baroro zigide barado. My God, yes, I hear, Lord. I hear, Lord. I hear, Lord. Mago City. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace, goodwill towards men. And I read from the Amplified. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Let me read from the verse 13, verse 13. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, I'll take it again. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, then it delved into the verse 14, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. So before the glory, before the peace, before the goodwill, there will be the multitude of the heavenly praising God. So we join the heavens to praise God. And as we do, my God, something we have never seen before. What have not entered the ear? What eyes have not seen? What ears have not heard? What has not entered the heart of man from this shout of praise 2023? My God, my God, my God, my God. Le gabo shakaba robos kepere. Can you stand to your feet at this moment? Maro sherede. Le kerebo sharababa ranande. It's time for that miracle. Instant miracle right now. Mago zegedo sharado sharade sherade. Whatever miracle you need, man's kopredeis. Let me tell you this. Hold on. Hold on. I got an information that somebody has taken another person's notepad and ATM cards. And what again? Is it found? Wallets. Containing what? So, has he left? Where is Dennis? All right. Let me tell you this. When you come to the house of God, you either take blessings or curses. Don't try it. Because especially if the person can hear me. If the person has left, it will still work. If the person is here and you can hear me, if you don't drop that thing, you will see what it means to have a man of God. You will see what a man of God is. I will release a word and you cannot escape it. So if you have mistakenly
maybe it's a mistake, taking somebody's wallet containing some cards. Is it a phone or a tablet? His phone is different from the tablet. He still has his phone. He has the phone. It's just a tablet. Writing my pad or something. So it's just a wallet that contains those things. Was there money inside? Don't take a curse. You can look around. If mistakenly you are seeing a wallet that is not for you. Because I'm here to release a blessing. Before I release the blessing, those of you up there, can you hear me? Are you sure you can hear me? Are you ready for your miracle? Are you ready for your healing? Are you ready for your miracle money? Receive it in the name of Jesus. Listen, before I do that, please help me talk to them. If you are here and you are not sure you are born again, born again does not mean you go to church. Born again does not mean you call yourself Christian. Born again is when you remember the day you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. Even if you are pastoring a church and you don't remember that day, you are not born again. At this moment, I want you to find your way to the front. Find your way to the front. You want to receive Christ. Before the miracle, come, keep coming. Please come. Let them come. Guide them to come. Find your way to the front. You want to receive Christ. Ushers, help them. All of you that want to receive Christ, come. If you don't receive Christ, you cannot get a miracle. Come to the front. Come to the front. Yes, please help. Where are the ushers? Help them to come. Come to the front. If you are not sure you are born again, come. Come and receive Christ. Once you receive that first miracle of salvation, every miracle will continue. Ah, these people. You want to receive Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. I'm doing just 3 minutes for this. After this, we'll enter the miracles. I didn't call for just teenagers. You are an adult. You are not sure you are born again. Come. Put your hand on your chest. Say, oh Lord God, I thank you for bringing me here. Thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, to die for me. Today, I receive your son, Jesus Christ, into my heart. I confess that Jesus is the Lord of my life. And I believe with all my heart that God raised Jesus from the dead. I am born again. I have salvation. I have the life of God in me. Thank you, Father, for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. You are born again. Congratulations. Go back to your seats. Go back to your seats. You are born again. And that's the first and the most important miracle. Osataka Baba.
Ra, da, 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 da. Da, 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 da. Da, da, da. Da 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 There's power, power. Lift your hands. Put your hand where you need a healing right now. Put your hand there. On your head. On your waist. On your neck. Wherever you need a healing. Put your hand there right now. Spirit of the Lord is here. You have to agree. You're not agreeing. Agree well. Check your rhythm. Check your rhythm. And agree well with the instrumentalist. There's power, power in this place. There's blood that fills the air.
An invention of his name.
Come on.
You are here. From glory to glory.
Spirit of the Lord. That same spirit,
that same spirit
that raised Jesus
from the dead,
healing your body,
makes you whole. Praise the Lord,
you are a miracle. Now, hold on. We are starting with healing miracles. I want you to testify right now. If you want the Lord to touch any part of your body specially, you already feel healed. But I want to confirm and complete that healing for you. Because the whole atmosphere is full of healing. I want you to come to the front. You want a special healing in any part of your body, please come. Just come to the front there. The Lord is going to touch you. Come. Anywhere you need healing, please come. Anyway, you need healing. Yes. No. Please guide them. Thank you. The Spirit of the Lord is here. That same Spirit that raised Jesus
from the dead.
I want to prove the power of God to you.
Praise the Lord. You have a miracle.
There's power,
power in this place.
Oh, yeah.
His presence fills the air.
Oh, yeah.
The mention of his name.
Satakara babaredebo shatara. From glory to glory, Spirit. In the name of Jesus. Can I have some pastors here now? Can I have some pastors?
Thank you,
Jesus.
Makes you whole. Praise the Lord.
Oh, shut up.
You have a miracle.
Hold on. If you need a miracle, lift your hands. Oh, as I'm talking to you, put your hands, those of you here, put your hands where you need that miracle. Put your hands there and lift the other hand. Put one hand on where you need a miracle and lift the other hand. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, sing it for me.
There's power in this place.
His
presence feels
so sarabaraba, sharabarabarabarabaraba.
At the mention of his name.
Sharabarabo, sharabarabo.
Glory to God.
In the name of Jesus.
Spirit of the Lord. Spirit of the Lord is He. That's the Spirit. That's the Spirit. Raise Jesus from the dead. Weakens your body. Makes you whole. Praise the Lord. You have a miracle.
Healed.
Now.
Healed. Be healed. It's gone. Now in the name of Jesus. Be healed.
At the mention of his name,
be healed. Be healed. Be healed.
From glory to glory.
You are healed.
Spirit of the
youth.
Lift your hands and give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed.
From glory to glory. Spirit of the Lord is healed. That's him feeling. That's him feeling. The rest of Jesus from the dead. Quick is your body. Makes you whole.
Lift your hands. Lift your hands and give him praise. Now, every other part you need healing in your life, financial healing especially, be healed in your pocket. In the name of Jesus. Listen, let me tell you this. I'm not even sure you took an offering, right? You didn't take an offering. Money is not our focus. But I would like you to sit down. Those of you in the auditorium, sit down. Take an envelope and give a seed to the program. If you are watching online, you can give your seed. Ushers, get envelopes for them. I don't know why you couldn't project. What's going on the projector? You couldn't project? Why? That is amazing. Take an envelope. Usher, please be fast. Take an envelope. Sow a seed. Give an offering for this program that has brought healing to you, that has brought beauty to you, that has brought peace to you. Just take a seed. I'm going to cause a multiplication on that seed. Let's be fast with it. There is none holy as the Lord, and there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God. There is none holy as the Lord. Can you pass the offering back? Let them give it. Holy as the Lord. There is none. There is none beside it. Is there any rock like God? There is none holy as the Lord.
In fact, I want to get all the choruses on the platform here. I want to bless you. Come here. All the choruses, come to this side. Shatakarababaraboshu. As you're going to be speaking in tongues, you put so much effort in this program. It's time for your blessing. It's time for your blessing. Lema shigi andorobro sharaba. The Lord wants to release a blessing unto the choir, special blessings. Gracious Father,
Lord of glory, there is no one like you. Beautiful Savior, wonderful Father, there is no one like you.
You're the gracious Father.
Gracious Father, there is no one like you.
Give your offerings.
Beautiful Savior.
beauty of creation.
You are holy
and gracious to me. I worship you.
Lord, I
stand in all of your mighty works. Beauty of
you
are holy.
Hold on. Thank you, Jesus. The choristers have been rehearsing day and night, all night, transport here and there. The Lord shall tell you, your efforts will never be in vain. He has added unto you multiplied grace. Whatever you desire to do, because of your participation in this shout of praise, the Lord grant it unto you. In the name of Jesus, special impartation for you. Grace to do things you have never done before. Some of you are going to get married. The right people are coming. The right husband is coming. The right wife is coming. God is opening doors to businesses unto you. In the name of Jesus, receive it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Special blessing for you. 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 Special blessing. Special blessing for you. 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 Lift your hands.
Beauty. Creation. You are holy and gracious to me.
You can come back. Come back to your stage.
Lord, I say, beauty of creation. You are holy.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Let's. Please stand to your feet. Let's all stand to our feet, finally. May the Lord bring waters to your deserts. Where others fail, you shall rise. By the close of this month of October, your heart desires will be surpassed. In the name of the Lord Jesus, whatever your hand touches shall prosper. By the power of the Holy Spirit, the whole atmosphere is erupted with God's presence, and you are living with that presence. When you check out of here, everybody will know that there's a glory that has come upon your life, and that glory will take you to the end of the year. There are some of you, the devil wanted to take your life by December. I cancel that debt in the name of Jesus. Some of you have things you want to buy, you want to sell. It shall be sold by the close of October in the name of Jesus. If you have difficulty in your marriage, the Lord grants you peace in your marriage, understanding in your marriage in the name of Jesus. All the pastors, multiplied grace for you. You have your venue. You have loyal people. By the power of the Holy Ghost, you will never go down in your ministry. In the name of Jesus, it shall be so. 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 In the name of Jesus, I bless you. In your going out and your coming in, you are blessed. You will never go down in your life. All the pastors in my group, the Lord is lifting you. The Lord is giving you even bigger venues. The Lord is granting you the grace to attract the right people. By the power of the Holy Ghost, you are living with the presence of the Lord. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. there shall be shout of praise in your mouth every day. In the name of Jesus, it shall be so. In Jesus' name. Come on, shout hallelujah. Listen, if you believe this holy, glorious presence has imparted your life, and therefore your life has moved from one level of glory to the other, peace has come to you, money comes to you, favor comes to you, promotion comes to you, divine health for your body, in the name of Jesus, we are going to shout seven hallelujah. Every hallelujah has its blessing. As we shout, you jump. If you are online, you can jump on your bed. You can jump on your seat. Wherever you are, you will jump. And as you jump, you are jumping your way out of the trouble. And you are taking your victory. Shout hallelujah! Come on! Woo! Hey! Hey! Number two. Shout hallelujah! Hey! This is number three. Let me tell you, I'm not just doing it. God told me to do it. As you shout, you are shouting your way out of the challenge. And you are taking your victories. This number three. As you shout, you give just three people a high five. And that high five means that, watch for me. Shout hallelujah! Give three people a high five. Watch out for me. Watch out for me. Watch out for me. Watch out. Hey! Watch out for me. Let me tell you. Hold on. God told me something just 3 weeks ago. Are you ready? Please, just a minute. God told me something 3 weeks ago. He said, a man of God doesn't have to preach a powerful message to bless you. There are people God has called and ordained them as men of God. When the man of God just look at your face, the blessing is released. When the man of God just walk and you see him, the blessing is released. Because the men of God, you know, you see that they don't struggle to get things done. Because the blessing is working. And in this number four, as you shout, blessings you have never seen before, you are taking it from this altar. Shout hallelujah! Right from this altar. Blessings, 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 blessings. Woo! 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 Number five. Listen. If we came to the church for this program and to shout just this seven hallelujah, it's enough. If I brought you from Tema or Kasua just to come and shout this seven, it's more than powerful. It will change everything. Number five. Shout hallelujah! This number six. There's a particular miracle. Some of you is marriage. You need that miracle. Some of you is money. Some of you is even childbirth. Whatever that miracle, you know that only God can give that thing.
As you shout this seventh hallelujah, the heavens break forth, left, right, center, and that miracle is granted you, and that miracle is delivered unto you. Shout hallelujah! Hey! That miracle! Woo! Hallelujah. Hold on. Tell your neighbor, look at me. You see me like this today? Tomorrow, come and see me. I have changed. This is the last hallelujah. You can pack your bag now. Before I shout that hallelujah, I'm going to give some announcements. So when we shout that hallelujah, you just take your bag. Your bags in tongues. If you have your husband here, you hug your husband. If you have your wife here, you hug your wife. He said, "Oni, it's good we came. We have it. And you speak in tongues. Till you get to the house. Kabashta Tabaya. There's a war. The people of Israel won by just shouting. Another war. They won by just singing. Shaka Tabasekiti. Maroko Tabaseti. Listen. That person I won. All this blessing, you can't take it. If you took somebody's wallet, you cannot take this blessing. Return it. Find a way in the world to come and deposit it. Because you are living with a curse. And I want everyone to live with a blessing. I don't like using the word curse. I don't like it. It's from hell. But I don't want it for you. Don't take anything that is not for you. Number two, we had some school that came with a bus. I'm sure the bus is already. Can you put on the outside light if it's not on? I'm sure the bus is already. So all the students, I am within time. In fact, we started the program at 3. So it's just a 3-hour program. We were supposed to start at 2. Everything was ready. But we're just waiting for you. We started at 3. And it's almost 6 now. We are close. It's just 3 hours. We have not spent time at all. And I thank God for how we have kept the time. So when we close, if you want to see me, especially the pastors and other people, I will have some time for you. I will take pictures with the choir. And then the ushers. If you want to see me personally, don't be in a rush. Sit down. Whatever God wants you to see me for, I will wait and see you. Are you ready for number 7? What do you want? I want you to speak it into the air. What do you want? Speak it into the air. I want the atmosphere to catch it. Speak it. Do you want money? Do you want marriage? Do you want a child? Do you want a house? Do you want healing? Are you ready for number 7? Do you believe in miracles? Do you believe that the miracles have happened already? From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, something has entered you. Then, ha 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 ha. Listen. For this last one, you have to jump. You jump like that, then you run. It's a big auditorium. Run where Amaro Oshe Abaro Andara Maskete Rabro Kati Rabro Shada Bado Barakadoya. Listen, Pastor Chris says, we cannot praise God when you are dancing in the flesh. Very true. But there are also some dance. You dance because you know you have the victory. And you're not dancing to the Holy Ghost. You just want to confirm the proof. That kind of dance, you can do it. So even if you have to add a dance, believing that you have your testimony, after jumping, After running, you can shake your body a bit. Say, devil, hey, hey, it has happened. It has happened. Somebody, are you ready? Are you ready? The Holy Ghost is here. Jesus is here. The Father is here. We agree and we shout, hallelujah. Hey, shout. Woo. Hey, 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 hey. You made it. You made it. You made it. You're unstoppable. You made it. You made it. Yeah, ba 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 ba, yeah. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. You are blessed. You are coming back next year for SOP in your own car, with your wife, with your husband, with your children. In the name of Jesus. Congratulations. God bless you. Give 10 people a high five. Say you made it. I love you. God bless you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, pastors. Thank you. Minutes. So please, we have seven service here tomorrow by 8 a.m. If you want to worship with us here, 8 a.m. tomorrow, we are here. And every Wednesday, the choir says, you can sing all your songs now. God bless you.
You are blessed.
Praise the Lord. Choruses.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Speak in tongues and thank God for 5 minutes. All the ushers, you can go down on your knees. Go down on your knees. Let's speak in tongues.